everyone, it's your girl Jackie, and guess what? It's tag video time! Yay! You guys know that I love me some tag videos just because it gives me a chance to give you guys a glimpse of what I'm like when I'm not focused on putting on makeup. I don't know who I'm kidding. I don't focus on nothing because you guys know even when I'm putting on makeup, I just make jokes the whole time and that's it. But okay, so at least now we don't have the makeup application to interfere with the jokes. So anyways, this tag video is called the Single Ladies Tag. This was created by Plus Model in the Making, and she is a guru here on YouTube who I discovered I think about a month and a half ago or so, and I just love her. I'm gonna link to her down below. Her name's Shakita, I think I'm saying it right. Do yourself a favor and subscribe to her because she is fabulous. I just love her. So I'm going to link to her below. So basically these questions are for the single gals because, you know, you've got the boyfriend tags and the relationship tags and all those. Us single girls didn't have a tag. So now we've got one. So I want you all to do this too, all my single girls, because I want to know. So anyways, let me just get right into it. The first question is, why are you single? And this question kind of cracks me up because my aunt just asked me this earlier today. She's like, you're so pretty. Why are you single? And it's one of those things where it's like, I don't think it has anything to do with like how pretty you are or how smart you are or what a good person you are. For me personally, I think I can sum it up just by saying that I got tired of dealing with crap. And the guys I tend to date provide me with a wide array of crap and shenanigans that I'm just not prepared to put up with anymore. It was different when I was in my 20s, you know, where I would stay in a relationship, even if I wasn't happy, just to stay in a relationship to have a boyfriend. These days, I'm kind of like, you know what, it's not really worth it. I think if you're not happy, you just need to move on and just find the next one. And I think my motto has kind of been, and this, actually my grandma always told me this when I was little, she would say, mijita, si el hombre no sirve, si te falta respeto, mándalo por un tubo. And the hand part's important, the little scoot yourself along. But anyways, what that translates to is if the guy's no good and if he doesn't respect you, get him the hell out of here. And that's kind of what I've been doing lately. And honestly, I think it's much easier and I'm a lot more sane these days because of that. Second question is, what do you love about being single? I think my favorite part about being single is not having anyone to answer to, because I see a lot of my friends with boyfriends. And, you know, we'll want to go out or something and they're like, oh, well, let me call home and check in. And if the boyfriend's like mad or whatever and has other plans, then they can't go out. And I remember those days and I don't miss that at all. I really love being able to come and go as I please, not have to check in with anybody. And I also love the fact that I have more time to work on personal projects such as YouTube and my beauty blog and that sort of thing, because I find that when I have a boyfriend, it's really hard to find time to do all these things because, you know, I'm constantly like hanging out with the other person and I have to like schedule times to do my YouTube and that sort of thing. Unlike now where, you know, if I'm just sitting around and I decide, you know what, I think I want to do a video, I just do one. I really like that a lot. And I like not having to worry about where my boyfriend is either, because yeah, that's not fun. Third thing, oh, okay, this is kind of a sad one. What do you miss most about being in a relationship and what do you replace it with? So, okay, I'll admit up front that I'm a relationship kind of girl. I prefer the comfort of being in a relationship. And so I do miss that. I miss a lot of things about being in a relationship. I would say the main thing is just having someone to come home to and cuddle with at the end of the day, and having someone to like talk to when funny things happen throughout the day or whatever, and you just want to text someone and just, hey honey, guess what just happened, haha. You know, I do miss that. What have I replaced it with? Shopping. And Shakita said that too, and I think most of you girls are gonna say the same thing. Shopping is the boyfriend replacement. When I'm feeling down or whatever, instead of like calling up a man and crying, I go shopping and it helps a lot. And I have a lot of really pretty things. And also, I think YouTube is kind of like my replacement boyfriend, because anytime I'm down or upset, I just come home and I make a video. And it makes me feel better. So I think those are like my main replacements. It's YouTube and shopping. And you know what? They don't talk back. They don't cheat. So I think I'm doing pretty good. Number four, what are they missing? And by they, it's like all your exes and whatever, like people you used to talk to, people who are no longer with you right now. What do they miss? What my exes miss about me, and this is what they tell me, because one by one, they've all come crawling back. All of them. and they all tell me the same thing. I could give the easy answers right now and say they miss my boobs or they miss my big booty and or whatever, and yes, I do have both, but you know what, ladies, men can find a girl with big boobs or a big booty or whatever it is that you have physically, you know, whatever superficial thing it is, they can find another girl with that. They can find a million girls with that on the street. You know, those things aren't hard to find. Those superficial things, they're not hard to find. You gotta bring something else to the table. The main thing that I hear from my exes that they miss is my sense of humor and my intelligence, because you can be physically sexy, but you know what? Anybody can be physically sexy. But to be sexy and smart or sexy and funny, that's what they're gonna miss about you. And that's what I hear a lot is a lot of my exes, that you, because you guys know I'm kind of a smart ass. What? You're a smart ass? Pfft. But yeah, I'm a smart ass, and a lot of guys actually kind of miss that, because then they date these girls who don't have the same kind of sense of humor and they can't take it as well as they can dish it out, and they miss that because I, you know, I can do that whole banter with the guys and I could tell a dirty joke like a sailor, okay? And I think that the other thing too that a lot of my exes miss, this is what the last one was telling me, was that he misses the way that I would take care of him, because I was brought up right, okay? I was raised by a Colombian mama who knows how to take care of a man, you know, and it's like 50-50, you know what I mean? It's not like one of those like subservient things. It's a 50-50 kind of thing. You take care of each other. But she took such good care of my dad. She would cook for him. She would do this. She would do everything for him. And I enjoy doing that for my boyfriends. If I'm with someone who I feel like deserves it and who I love, I enjoy cooking for him. I enjoy, you know, rubbing his back after a hard day. I like doing all those things. And I think that a lot of my exes, they get out there, you know, once we break up, and they see that not every girl is like that. And then they really miss me and they come crawling back and they're sorry that they did what they did to get exed in the first place. And it's too late when that happens, but those are the things that they miss. You know, not the boobs, not the booty. Well, okay, they probably do miss those too, but you know, it's the other things too that are more important. Okay, and number five, when is the last time you rejected someone and how? I love this question. So I'm actually gonna go into two. So the first one, the last time I rejected someone, this is someone I was seeing a couple months ago. I'm not gonna name any names or anything because that's just kind of like immature. I'm not gonna do that. But basically what happened was we had been dating like on and off actually for like a couple years, I think. Like there was a really long off period and then we reunited briefly and da da da. You guys know how all that drama all goes. So anyways, I'm over there. It's like a Saturday afternoon. We're taking a nap because I was really tired. He was tired, whatever. So we're cuddling. He's holding me with one arm, right? And so I kind of wake up for a minute and I notice that he's like really fidgety and he's moving a lot. So I kind of look out of the corner of my eye and this fool is texting another girl. So he's holding me with one arm and he's texting another girl with the other. And I ain't having that, obviously, as my grandma says. So basically I was out of there fast and he kind of like, he texted her and then he fell back asleep right away. So I got out of there. I didn't even wait for him to wake up. I was just gone. I was out. And then it's like funny because he woke up like as I was leaving and he's like, baby, where are you going? And I was like, I didn't even say anything. I just left. Later on that day, I like texted him and I was just like, what the hell, you know? And he's like, I don't know what you're talking about. I was asleep. Oh, wait, that's the thing. That's the funny thing too. He texted me with, I don't know what you're talking about. I was asleep. Let's just, I was asleep. I was asleep. Mm-hmm. He is asleep. Did you know that? My ex-boyfriend is asleep. That's awesome. But yeah, so, and he kept calling and texting. And it's kind of funny because he like on his Facebook and his Twitter would talk about, oh, stop looking so desperate, girl, and da-da-da-da. Like, so people would think that he dumped me, and everyone was like, okay, dude, we already know the story. She dumped you, idiot, you know? Yeah, so that didn't go so well. And this guy was older, too. I thought he was mature, not so much. And then the second one. So that's the most recent time I rejected someone. Let's hear about the funniest time that I rejected someone. So this was a couple years ago, and I will preface this by saying that I did date him for a little bit after that, and then again, earlier this year. But basically what happened, this was our first date, and it was a couple years ago. It was the night of the first presidential debate. That's how long ago this was. So I was getting ready to leave for our date. I was at work. I was watching the debate on my computer at work, and it wasn't over yet and I wanted to finish watching it. So I called him and was like, hey, you know, do you mind if we meet up a little bit later? I want to finish watching the debates. And I didn't know exactly how stupid he was. And you know how I said, like, I need an intelligence is important. You gotta be smart to be sexy, right? I found out then that he wasn't that smart, and I'll tell you why. So I said, again, I want to finish watching the debates. And his reply was, and I'm gonna need you to brace yourselves because it's pretty stupid. He said, "Who is D. Bates?" He's really cute. He's really cute. He's really cute. He's really cute. You're going because he's cute. You're going because he's cute. Yeah, did you guys absorb that? So I started laughing right away because I thought it was a joke. It was not a joke. He really asked me, "Who is D. Bates?" And I was like, so then I was just kind of like, the presidential debates, as in like Obama and John McCain are having a debate. And so his response was, "Oh, I don't care about that. That don't affect me." So that should have been my first red flag right there. But yeah, so I ended up ending things with that guy. He was just too dumb for me to make it work. And I know this sounds terrible, but how can anyone be that stupid? This is the kind of story, you guys, that like I told all my friends and they were just like, "You've got to be freaking kidding me. That's not true. That is not true. Please don't tell me anyone is that stupid. That really happened." This is the kind of people I date, okay? I don't know why I attract these people. I don't know. So anyways, that completes the tag. You know, I just want to say, because I know that I have a lot of male viewers, and I hope that this doesn't come off as like male bashing, because it's not. And ladies, there are good men out there. There are. I just haven't found them yet. I'm still looking. But you know, it's one of those things where you just have to find the right guy, and you have to make sure that you're not with the wrong guy when the right guy comes along. And I know, like, I'm not one of these girls who's like upset about being single. I know there are girls who are, but I'm just gonna leave you guys with this. My Aunt Miriam, the one that I call Lala, the one that, you know, she's been sick or whatever, she told me this earlier in the year when I had a breakup, and I was like, "God, I don't know why it didn't work out." I was talking to her about it, and she told me something that just really stuck out in my mind, and it's really helped me since then. And she said, "It didn't work out because he was looking too high and you were looking too low. That's why you're single right now." And that, to me, that just like really resonated with me, because I was like, you know what? That's true. I was looking too low and he was looking too high. That's why it didn't work out. And I want you guys to think about that too. If you're down on yourself for being single, or you just had a breakup, there's a reason why it didn't work out. You know, and who knows, maybe this time next year you'll be doing the relationship tag or the husband tag. Oh, Lord Jesus, I hope not. But, you know, so it's cool, you know, be single, have fun, enjoy it, you know, dance that Beyonce song. I tag all of you, and I basically want everyone watching this video to do this tag and post it as a response down below. But I am going to pick out a couple of you guys, a couple of my guru friends who I know make videos, and you better do the tag video because I want to see your answers. So I'm going to name you guys down below in the information box once I pick you, and I hope you guys have enjoyed this video. Thank you so much, Shakita, for A, making this tag, and B, for tagging me to do it, because I really did enjoy talking about all this. And I got to share the debate story to everybody. Mm-hmm. Forever will be known as the girl that dated the guy that thought D. Bates was a real dude. Yeah. Okay. So anyways, I'm off to bed. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye.